So before going into some algorithms, we should know about some terminology in the cryptography. So first one is the plain text. This is the actual message sender wants to send to receiver. So this is actual message. If I want to say hi to my receiver, I say hi, hello. That hi, hello is called a plain text. And the cipher text is, this is unintelligible text and normal person cannot understand this. So I perform some operation on my plain text to get this cipher text. And I will send this cipher text to my receiver. And encryption. The process of converting this plain text into cipher text is called encryption. Okay, the actual process I am doing on the plain text is called encryption. After encryption, I get the cipher text. And the decryption. The process of converting cipher text into plain text is called decryption. So on the receiver side, the receiver should perform this operation called decryption. And this process automatically converts the ciphertext into plain text. So encryption should be performed at the sender side and decryption should be performed at the receiver side. And cryptanalysis, the study of understanding how crypto algorithms works and finding weaknesses. This process is exactly like decryption, but it's not. Cryptanalysis don't know how this process has worked, like encryption and decryption, but cryptanalysis is study of understanding how algorithms work and finding weaknesses. So if I use this weak mathematical model or just simple mathematical model for converting the plain text into ciphertext, then any other can guess these algorithms and they can just decipher their own way. Even though they did not 100% decipher the plain text, they can get the intention what I want to send the message to the receiver. So the person who does this cryptanalysis process is called cryptanalyst. So we have discussed about the Alan Turing, right? So he is mathematician and cryptanalyst because he does not know how Enigma cipher works, but he studies the algorithm and he observes the some cipher text, how it's being converted from the plain text. And by finding the weaknesses, and he deciphered the Enigma cipher. In that way, cryptanalysis works. And the first one we are going to see about different ciphers is substitution cipher. So the name implies the substitution. So we are substituting something instead of our plain text. So this cipher simply replaces the plain text character with some other characters. So these are called substitution ciphers. So these substitution ciphers are good but also somewhat easy to crack. Like if I put every other substitution, like all ASCII characters substitution, I may get so many paragraphs, but in that all paragraphs, one paragraph may be our plain text. So this is like basic ciphers. And next one is block ciphers. These ciphers operate on some block of bits. So you take some block of bits, let's say 32 bit or 64 bit, and these ciphers operates on those bits. Examples are DES algorithms and AES algorithms. And symmetric encryptions, the same key used at the encryption side and as well as decryption side. So there is some key used at the encryption side and also at decryption side. So this key is very like heart of this mathematical operation performing on the plain text, and with this key only the receiver can decrypt at the other side. So one good thing about the symmetric encryptions are these encryptions are very fast and also very fast for decryption. But the disadvantage is if the key was seen or got by another person, they can use the same key for the decryption. So that's, you need to safely secure the key to the receiver side. And next one is asymmetric encryptions. Public key is used for encryption and private key used for decryption. So in these encryptions, we use two keys. One is called public key and it can be used by anyone because public key is used for encryption only. Even the attacker or hacker knows this public key, he cannot do anything. And the private key is used for decryption. So this is a very important key you need to safely send to the receiver, or receiver should know already. This private key is used only for decryption. If this is known by hacker, then this encryption fails. he knows the plain text. So this private key should be stored securely. The next one we are going to see the digital certificate. These certificates are used to establish a secure connection between sender and receiver. So example is SSL certificate, secure socket area certificate. You can see this SSL certificate in your websites like HTTPS, like secure socket area, like 128 bit encryption and so on. So even though if you are using plain text protocols like HTTP, but if you have this SSL certificate, you can establish a secure connection between sender and receiver. Secure in the sense encrypted connection between sender and receiver. So your data will go encrypted and also automatically decrypted at the receiver. That is use of the digital certificate. And I always recommend to install this SSL certificate for your websites. So these are all about the basic terms you need to know to get started into cryptography. I think if there is another term, we come into our next slides or next videos, then I will explain that term in that video.